the soldiers celebrated the praise of the Holy One. And in their presence was kindled a fire that raged on high. On Tuesday they put on their dark brown garments. On Wednesday they purified their enameled armor. On Thursday their destruction was certain. On Friday was broad carnage all around. On Saturday their joint labor was useless. On Sunday their blades assumed a ruddy hue. On Monday was seen a pool knee-deep of blood. The Gododdin relates that after the toil, before the tents of Madoc, when he returned, only one man in 100 with him came. At the early dawn of morn, there was a battle at the fall of the river, in front of the course. The pass and the knoll were pervaded with fire. Like a boar didst thou lead to the mount, the wealth of the hill, and the place. And the dark brown hawks were stained with gore. Quickly rising, in a moment of time, after kindling a fire at the confluence, in front of the fence, after leading his men in close array, in front of 100 he pierces the foremost. Sad it was that you should have made a pool of blood, as if you but drank meat in the midst of laughter. But it was brave of you to slay the little man with the fierce and impetuous stroke of the sword. For like the unrestrained ocean had the foe put to death. A man, who would otherwise have been in rank his equal. He fell headlong down the precipice. And the bushes supported not his noble head. It was a violation of privilege to kill him on the breach. It was a primary law that Owen should ascend upon the course. And extend before the onset the branch of peace. And that he should pursue the study of meat and learn strains. Excellent man, the assuager of tumult and battle, whose very grasp dreaded a sword, and who bore in his hand an empty corslet. O sovereign, dispense rewards out of his earthly shrine. Idle, with frigid blood and pale complexion, spreading carnage, when the maid was supreme in judgment, owner of horses and strong trappings, and transparent shields, instantaneously makes an onset, ascending and descending. The leader of war with eagerness conducts the battle. Mallet of the land, he loved the mighty reapers. Stout youth, the freshness of his form was stained with blood. His accoutrements resounded, his chargers made a clang. His cheeks are covered with armor. And thus, image of death, he scatters desolation in the toil. In the first onset his lances penetrate the targets. And a track of surrounding light is made by the aim of the darting of his spears. The saints exert their courage, for the destruction of thy retreat. And the cellar, which contained, and where was brewed, the mead, that sweet ensnare. With the dawn desires make the battle clash. Fair gift, marshal of the Loegrian tribes. Penance he inflicts until repentance ensues. May the dependents of Gwynedd hear of his renown. With his ashen shaft he pierces to the grave. Pike of the conflict of Gwynedd. Bull of the host, oppressor of the battle of princes. Though thou hast kindled the land before thy fall, at the extreme boundary of Gododdin will be thy grave. Involved in vapors was the man accustomed to armies. High-minded, bitter-handed leader of the forces. He was expert, and ardent, and stately. Though at the social banquet he was not harsh. They removed and possessed his valuable treasures. And not the image of a thing for the benefit of the region was left. We are called. The sea and the borders are in conflict. Spears are mutually darting, spears all equally destructive. Impelled are sharp weapons of iron, gashing is the blade. And with a clang the sock descends upon the potty. A successful warrior was Flumder against the enemy. He supported martial steeds and harness of war. Drenched with gore, on the red-stained field of Catraeth. The foremost shaft in the host is held by the consumer of forts. The brave dog of battle, upon the towering hill. We are called to the gleaming post of assault. By the beckoning hand of Hydin, the ironclad chief. The sovereign, who is celebrated in the Gododdin. The sovereign, for whom our eyelids weep. From the raging flame of Ethan turned not aside. He stationed men of firmness in command. And the thick covering guard he placed in the van. And vigorously he descended upon the scattered foe. In that he had reveled, he likewise sustained the main weight. Of the retinue of Mighty Dog, none escaped. Save one man by slow steps, thoroughly weakened, and tottering every way. Having sustained a loss, Morid bore no shield. But traversed the strand to set the ground on fire. Firmly he grasped in his hand a blue blade. and a shaft ponderous as the chief priest's crozier. He rode a grey stately-headed charger. And beneath his blade there was a dreadful fall of slaughter. When overpowered he fled not from the battle. Even he who poured out to us the famous mead, that sweet ensnarer. I beheld the array from the highland of Adayan. And the sacrifice brought down to the omen fire. I saw what was usual, a continual running towards the town. And the men of Mwithon inflicting sharp wounds. I saw warriors in complete order approaching with a shout. And the head of Dibnalbrich by ravens devoured. Blessed conqueror, of temper mild, the strength of his people. With his blue streamers displayed towards the sea roving foes. Brave is he on the waters, most numerous his host. Manly his bosom, loud his shout in the charge of arms. Usual was it for him to make a descent before nine armaments. With propulsive strokes, in the face of blood and of the country. I love thy victorious throne, which teemed with harmonious strains. O Sindeling of Aaron, thou lion's whelp. I could wish to have been the first to shed my blood in Catraeth. As the price of the mead and beverage of wine in the hall. I could wish to have been hurt by the blade of the sword. Ere he was slain on the green plain of Apin. I love the son of renown, who sustained the bloody fight. And made his sword descend upon the violent. Can a tale of valor be related before Gododdin? In which the son of Cedil has not his fame as a man of war? Sad it is for me, after all our toil. To suffer the pang of death through indiscretion. And doubly grievous and sad for me to see. Our men falling headlong to the ground. Breathing the lengthened sigh, and covered with reproaches. After the strenuous warriors have extended their country's bounds. Ruvon and Gwon and Gledged. Men at their post most gallant, valiant in difficulties. May their souls, now that their conflict is ended, be received into the heavenly region, the abode of tranquility. Trace repelled the foe through a pool of gore, and slaughtered like a hero such as asked no quarter. With a sling and a spear, he flung off his glass goblet, containing the mead, and in defense of his sovereignty overthrew an army. His counsel always prevailed, and the multitude would not speak before him. Whilst those that were cowards were not left alive. Before the onset of his battle axes, and his sharpened sword, and where his blue banner was seen to wave, there was a reinforcement of troops, a supply of penetrating weapons, and a host of men in the vanguard, presenting a menacing front. In the days of strenuous exertion, in the eager conflict, they displayed their valor. After the intoxication, when they drank the mead, not one was spared, though Gorlum was a while successful. When the retort was made, it broke the charge of the horses and men, by fate decreed. When the host of Prider arrives, I anxiously count the bands. 11 complete battalions. There is now a precipitate flight along the road of lamentation. Affectionately have I deplored. Dearly have I loved the illustrious dweller of the wood and the men of Argode, accustomed, in the open plain, to marshal their troops. For the benefit of the chiefs, the lord of the war, laid upon rough boards, midst a deluge of grief, the viands for the banquet, where they caroused together, he conducted us to a bright fire, and to a carpet of wide and fresh hide. Geraint, from the south, did raise a shout, and on the white water was his buckler pierced. Lord of the spear, a gentle lord, the praise of mountain and sea, will he render our youth, even thou, Geraint, wilt render them, who hast been a generous commander. Instantaneously as his fame wafted on high, his anchors from the scene of action cannot be restrained. Unflinching eagle of the forward heroes, he bore the toil, and brilliant was his zeal. The fleetest coursers he outstripped in war, but was quite a lamb when the wine from the goblet flowed. Ere he reached the grassy tomb, and his cheeks became pale in death, he presided over the banquet of mead, and honored it with a generous horn. Ruin he brought upon every fair region, and a fettering valor he displayed. The front of his shield was pierced. Kossohr, when roused to anger, defended Ruven Iog. A second time they challenged, and were crushed by the warlike steeds with gory trappings. His martial nobles formed a firm array, and the field was reddened, when he was greatly affronted. Severe in the conflict, with blades he slaughtered. And sad news from the war he brought, which he wove into a song for the Calends of January. Adon, the son of Ervi, there did pierce. Adon pierced the haughty boar. Even he, who was like a dame, a virgin, and a hero. And when the youth thus possessed the properties of a king, he, stained with blood, brought deliverance to Gwynedd. Ere the turf was laid upon the gentle face of the generous dead, but now undisturbed. In regard to fame and gain, he reposes in the grave. Namely, Garth was her, from the land of Reuben Iog. The garment of Tinagad, which was of divers colors, made of the speckled skins of young wolves. His jerks and starts and juggling motion, I fain would lampoon, they were lampooned by his 8 slaves. When thy father went out to hunt, with his pole upon his shoulder, and his provisions in his hand, he would call to his dogs that were of equal size. Catch it, seize it, bring it, bring it. He would kill a fish in his coracle, even as a princely lion in his fury kills his prey. When thy father climbed up the mountain, he brought back the head of a roebuck, the head of a wild boar, the head of a stag, the head of a grey moorhen from the hill, the head of a fish from the falls of the Derwent. As many as thy father could reach with his flesh piercer, of wild boars, lions, and foxes. It was certain death to them all, unless they proved too nimble. Were he to narrow my dominions through extortion, the arrival of no enemy would prove to me more formidable. The man has not been nursed who could be more festive in the hall than he, or steadier in the field of battle. On the fort of Pencluid Pennant were his steeds. Far spread was his fame, compact was his armor. And ere the long grass covered him beneath the sod, he, the only son of Morark, poured out the horns of meat. I saw the array from the highland of Adon, carrying the sacrifice to the omen fire. I saw the two, who from their station quickly and heavily fell. By the commands of Mwithon, greatly were they afflicted. I saw the warriors, who had made the great breach, approaching with the dawn, and the head of Divnalverch by ravens devoured. Gododdin, in respect of thee will I demand, in the presence of 100 that are named with deeds of valor, and of Gwarth and the son of Dwywau, of gallant bravery, let Treasid be ours in one entire dale. Since the stabbing of the delight of the bulwark of battle, since an iron was underground, my voice has not been divorced from Gododdin. Echo speaks of the formidable and dragon-like weapons, and of the fair game, which was played in front of the unclaimed course of Gododdin. Profusely did he bring a supply of wine into the tents, for the benefit of the natives, in the season of the storm, as long as it trickled from the vessels. And the army, a well-nourished host, continued to drop in. A splendid troop of warriors, successful against 100 men, is led from Dindovid and Dyvnig. Before Dolu in battle, worn out were the shields, and battered the helmets. He brought ruin upon every fair region, and a fettering valor he displayed. The front of his shield was pierced. Kosoher, arrayed in pomp, protected Reuben Iog. A second time were they wounded, and crushed. By his warlike steeds, and gore-stained were their coffins. Always immovable, always liberal of aid, would be his gallant nobles, when roused to anger. Severe in the conflict, with blades he slaughtered. And agonizing news from the war he brought, which he wove into 100 songs for the Calends of January. Adon the son of Ervi there did pierce. Adon pierced the haughty boar. Even he who was like Urien, a maid, and a hero. And as the youth was thus endowed with the properties of a king, lord of Gwynedd, and of the blood of Sil, he proved our deliverer. Ere the turf was laid upon the face of the generous dead, wisely did he seek the field, with praise and high-sounding fame. The grave of Gorth and her is seen from the highlands of Reuben Iog, on account of the piercing of the skillful and most learned man, on account of the fair corpse, which fell prostrate upon the ground. Thrice 6 officers judged the atrocious deed at the hour of matins, and Morian lifted up again his ancient lance, and, roaring, stretched out death towards the warriors, the Gwyddle, and the Pridon, whilst towards the lovely, slender, blood-stained body of Gwen, sighed Wenabwy, the only son of Gwen. On account of the afflicting of the skillful and most learned man. Grievously and deeply, when he fell prostrate upon the ground. The banner was pompously unfurled, and borne by a man in the flag. A tumultuous scene was beheld in Aiden, and on the battlefield. The grasp of his hand performed deeds of valor. Upon the Sint, the Gwydl, and the Pridan. He who meddles with the mane of the wolf, without a club in his hand, will have it gorgeously emblazoned on his robe. Fain would I sing, would that Morion had not died. I sigh for Gwenabwy, the son of Gwen.